Recursion is a fundamental technique of computer science which can be applied to solve many types of problems. But how it works exactly? Simply put, recursion is a function that calls itself. Recursion can be applied whenever a problem can be solved by dividing it into smaller problems that can use the same algorithm for solving them. Recursive function is like a Russian doll. Each time you open a doll, a smaller one will be inside, and you repeat the process until you reach the smallest doll which doesn't contain another one. Let's reverse a string using recursion. Recursive function must have an end condition to determine if it should call itself again or not. In this case, if the string is empty, we won't make another recursive call. And here's where the recursion actually happens. The function calls itself with a parameter, which is a substring of our string, starting at the index 1. So what we return is a result of our new call plus the first character of the input string. Let's see how it works step by step. The function calls are nested, and they are a nice example of stack. The last call returns as the first one, and the first call returns as the last one. And that's it. When it comes to algorithms, every algorithm using recursion can be rewritten to use iteration instead, and vice versa. In imperative language such as C or Java, due to performance, it is preferred to use iteration over recursion. This doesn't apply to functional programming languages, where the use of recursion is very common. So what can be recursion used for? Sorting algorithms can be implemented using recursion. Also, finding files in directory structure or parsing XML or HTML file. You may have even seen recursive acronyms such as GNU, which stands for GNU is not Unix, or PHP, which stands for PHP Hypertext Preprocessor. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe to see more videos like this in future.